Can I ask, what do you think is the significance of Elon Musk's potential takeover of Twitter and how this relates to free speech? Why is Elon Musk regarded as a distinct billionaire as opposed to the other billionaires that own other comparable sites? And what are your concerns around the subject of free speech? And do you think that what we're witnessing is a curation of new public spaces in order to ensure that grassroots movements cannot compete?
It is because they are so threatened by a free people who can think for ourselves, speak our mind and our views and our beliefs, very robustly engage in this marketplace of ideas. That scares them. That scares the power elite who are in charge. So of course, and this includes some of these billionaires who are so afraid to stand up and take a stand like Elon Musk has. It's why he's gotten such a backlash with his purchase of Twitter and his true commitment stringently to free speech, whether you like it or not, which by the way, the ACLU and Democrats used to be that. They used to be those champions of speech, no matter how abhorrent that speech might be. What's dangerous about what's happening here is with Elon Musk continuing to forge ahead very correctly in his commitment to free speech and how he wants to change Twitter to be a truly free marketplace of ideas, the power elite are so threatened by it that they are launching the muscle of the federal government against him, basically saying, well, we're going to just start investigating Elon Musk. We need to start looking at what rules he may have broken or what regulations he may not be following. Not because they've got evidence of any wrongdoing, but here's a guy who poses a threat to them because they want to be the ones to say, well, these are the only voices we want heard. This is what we deem to be information versus disinformation. Nobody else gets to do that but us. They're afraid of a free people with free voices and a free society, and that's why it's dangerous as we are seeing how they are trying to take down people like Elon Musk, who has the means and resources to actually join the people in standing up and fighting to uphold those freedoms, obviously here in the United States, but with Twitter, it affects people around the world.